One, two.
I like that. I like that. There's one national cross for you. There's a lot of room at the cross for a lot of people, right? So they make the right decision today. Today could be your day of repentance and salvation. They go hand in hand. Repentance and salvation. Just like milk shake. That's right. Without the milk, there's no shake. Amen. Let us read Psalm 23, the Psalm of David. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restored my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for His name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for Thou art with me. Thy rod and Thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. You know why I love this passage, Sister Joyce, my lady? Because it's a passage for your walk of life with Jesus. It's a good passage for your everyday walk, and it should stick and stay with you all day until Jesus comes. Amen. Amen, amen. Because with Jesus and through His blood, we are worthy. We are worthy. Amen. So when you walk with Jesus and He gave you the victory, consider yourself worthy because you open your eyes so that you can see. When you accept Jesus as your Savior and He is your Lord, consider yourself worthy. Count yourself worthy because just as you have brought us forth. When you give up everything in His Word and you accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and He made a way for you when there seems to be no way, count yourself worthy because it's victory every single day. When you have the victory and you can see, count yourself worthy because it's Jesus who sets you free. When you know it was Jesus who was there for you when you was in despair, count yourself worthy because Jesus was with you everywhere. Amen? Yeah. Lord, I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. That means no matter what obstacles we face in this world, Jesus is always with me no matter what I go through. Because it's not about me anymore and what I can do. It's about Jesus and what He can do for you. Amen. I don't have to have no matter fought for me. Because I am clean. And it's Jesus who fought off my father and my daughter, seen and unseen. So I don't worry about what this world throws at me. Because I have an advocate. I have a defender. I have a lawyer who fights on my body. I have a comforter. I have a counselor. And I have a best friend who loves me to no end. Amen. So I don't want to hear anybody say, well, I can't. When it comes to Jesus, I want you to say, I can, because with Jesus, you can. But there's such thing as I can't in the kingdom of God. Am I right about it? All we know is I can. And my second one is, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
That's my everyday motto. Amen.
That's my everyday motto. And I can. I can walk on through Christ. I'm certain of him. You know what I'm saying? No matter what I go through, no matter what I do, I know Jesus is always going to help me to see it through. Amen. And he will do the same for you, and you. Amen. This is to help you to get saved, gospel. Not to help you to feel good, gospel. We don't care if you feel good or not. We're not here to help you to feel good. You can go to your local bar and do that. That's not what we're about. We're here to help you to get saved. And after you get saved, you will feel good. Am I right about it? Matter of fact, you feel more than good. There's no words that can describe how you will feel after you know Jesus and walk with Jesus every day. And you have accepted him as your Savior. And he's the one who made a way for you when there seems to be no way. He's the one that set you free. He's the one that gave you the victory. He's the one that opened your eyes so that you can see. He's the one that snatched you from that evil grasp of Satan. He's the one that opened your eyes and showed you the mistakes that you were making. With Jesus, nothing is impossible. So I don't want to hear anybody say, I can't use my game. I did. I don't want to hear anybody say, so I can't stop being an alcoholic. I did. I don't want to hear anybody say, I can't live with a covered lifestyle. I can't leave it no more. I did. And you know how I did it? I can say I did because Jesus did it for me. A lot of people think there's a lot of work to be done in order to be saved, in order to follow Jesus. You gotta work. You can't work for it. There's no work involved. The Holy Spirit is all the work. All you gotta do is accept Jesus. The Holy Spirit does the rest. He'll give you the transformation and save you from the desolation of this wicked nation. That's the Holy Spirit's job. It's not your job. Your job is to accept Jesus and to repent, and the Holy Spirit does the rest. The Holy Spirit will do a work in you that you've never seen anybody or anything else do, because only the Holy Spirit can do it for you. So I don't want to hear anybody say, well, I've done so much, or I don't want to lose this lifestyle because I love it so much and I can't change. You can! With Jesus, you can! Let me put it like this. With Jesus, everything is possible. But without Jesus, nothing is possible. Nothing is possible. And we're talking about salvation and your walk in this world, your final destination. Nothing is possible without the blood of Jesus. Without the blood. Oh, how precious that blood of Jesus is. How precious is that blood of Jesus.
It's so precious it can change a multitude of nations with one single drop. Because he did it all at the cross so that we wouldn't be lost. He did it all at the tree to give us the victory for you and me. And he helped us to see. No longer walking in darkness and no longer walking in sin. It's Jesus who lives within. Amen. It's not a work that you do, it's a work that the Holy Spirit does through Jesus for you. Am I right about it? Yeah. Yeah.
So stop saying, oh, I can't do it, it's too hard. I can't walk that life. You know what?
Wide is the road to the world and to damnation, but narrow is the gate to heaven. Narrow is the road to the gate of heaven.
Amen. And most people in this world choose the wide road. Why?
Because they want the easy and the fast life. But that evening of your last night is going to send you to eternal despair and damnation. So choose today whom you shall serve. You can't serve two masters.
Amen.
Because the only thing that Satan comes to do is to steal, kill, and destroy. It's roaring lion. He's like a roaring lion. Seeking whom he may devour. Don't let him devour you. Don't let him tear up your flesh. Because you're falling prey to his schemes.
You gotta be like us Christians out here every day.
You know what I'm saying? When Satan shoots those arrows at us. When he shoots those fire arrows at us. And I say, it just bounces right off of me. I say, stop tickling me, Satan. Get away.
You got that power and authority over the evil one when you have Jesus, because he's the one that sets you free.
And he said, you know, you are the king, and so shall you.
He said, you are a God that is conqueror,
and there's nothing you can't do.
You have controlling power over the evil one.
He no longer has a residence in your body anymore.
Amen.
He no longer has a residence in your body because
light cannot go.
I mean, darkness cannot go where the light is. The darkness runs from the light. The darkness runs from the light.
So consider the holy temple of God, which is your body.
Consider your body the holy temple of God.
And if you don't have Jesus in your holy temple, you just Satan permission to do a hostile takeover of your holy temple.
It's going to do a hostile takeover of your house because you let him in.
You let him in.
I'm tired of people saying the devil made me do it.
The devil didn't make you do anything. You let him in. The devil had to have permission to enter your body, to enter your holy temple.
He's not going to do anything because he needs permission. He needs permission from God to add his will.
Amen.
But when you let the devil into your holy temple, you gave him permission. And now your house is condemned. Your house is condemned because you let the evil one in.
But Jesus
can take the evil one out of your body and take the convincing off your chest and tell the Father in heaven, he is mine. She is mine.
Amen.
And the devil cannot inhabit my temple anymore.
It will be evicted by the blood of Jesus.
He's been evicted by the blood.
Amen.
Amen.
So stop saying I can't. And start saying I can. And start saying I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Amen.
Because it's not about what you can do, it's about what Jesus and the Holy Spirit can do for you.
Amen.
Because you can't do nothing of yourself.
You can't make yourself righteous.
You can't give yourself salvation.
Amen. Only Jesus can do those things for you.
Amen.
All you gotta do is accept him.
It's like doing Romans 10:9.
Go home and study Romans 10:9.
Open your Bible.
Dust the cobwebs off.
Dust the dust off of your Bible.
And go to Romans 10:9.
Amen.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Because this life that we're living right now, living it our way without Jesus, it's not going to work.